Today, let us talk about lab diagnosis of tuberculosis. Myself, Dr. Taruna, and I am associate professor in microbiology at SP Medical College, Bikaner. As we all know that tuberculosis is diagnosed by progressive fatigue, malaise, anorexia, and weight loss. And pulmonary tuberculosis patient comes with complaint of chronic cough, which is productive, or sputum may be there, night sweats are there, hemoptysis is there, and chest pain and low grade fever, especially in the evening or late afternoon, is there. The various traditional method for diagnosing tuberculosis, they are on clinical diagnosis, radiological diagnosis. We can go for acid fast bacilli microscopy, Jaden staining, tuberculin test can be done, pathological examination of biopsy can be done, and definitive diagnosis can be done only by isolation and identification of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. There can be pulmonary tuberculosis, there can be extrapulmonary tuberculosis. What samples to take in pulmonary and extrapulmonary tuberculosis, and what are various acceptance and rejection criteria that we will take. In case of pulmonary tuberculosis, the samples taken or specimens to be taken, they are sputum, laryngeal aspirate, bronchial washing, and gastric lavage. Gastric lavage is taken in children who are unable to produce sputum. Then in extrapulmonary tuberculosis, we can take CSF in case of suspected meningitis, bone marrow biopsy, liver biopsy, if internal organ tuberculosis is suspected. Pus sample we can take in any exudate collection, etc. Pleural effusion can be taken if collection of fluid in pleural cavity is there. In genitourinary tuberculosis, we can take urine sample, and peritoneal fluid or ascitic fluid can be taken if we are suspecting peritoneal tuberculosis, and in extrapulmonary tuberculosis, we can take blood sample also. Now, decontamination and concentration of a specimen, especially sputum, is required because this can contain normal flora. So, we have to remove the normal flora or we have to inactivate them before processing the sample for culture. So there are two methods of decontamination and concentration of a specimen. One is Petrops method, in which we use 4% NaOH. The other method is NALC method, in which we use N-acetyl L-cysteine, which liquefies the sputum, and NaOH is decontaminating agent, so this will kill the normal flora. So we can add in equal volume of sputum 4% NaOH. We keep at 37 degrees centigrade for 20 minutes. Frequent shaking in between is done. Thereafter, centrifugation at 3000 RPM for 30 minutes is done. And then sediment is used for smear preparation and culture. In case of NALC, NaOH and N-acetyl L-cysteine both are used, and this NALC method is superior as compared to Petrops method for decontamination and concentration of a specimen. Now, sputum examination can be done by direct microscopy, and this is a gold standard method of diagnosing tuberculosis, and this can be done at the level of PSC and CSC also. How the sputum is collected? On day one, as soon as the patient comes and we diagnose clinically as having tuberculosis, then on the spot sample is taken up, and on day two sample, the patient will bring the early morning sputum sample, as the chances of recovery of tubercle bacilli from early morning samples are more. And this is how sputum microscopy is done. We prepare a smear from sputum and then dry it, and after fixation, this is subjected for Jaden staining, application of a strong carbolfuxin, thereafter heated strong carbolfuxin either we can add, or after adding strong carbolfuxin we can heat the slide, and then decolorization with acid alcohol or 20% H2SO4 is done, and finally application of methylene blue as a counter stain is done, and we can examine this smear under microscope for presence of acid fast bacilli. There is one more method of staining tubercle bacilli, which is modified kinion staining, in which there is no need of heated carbolfoxin because we have added more phenol in the carbolfoxin, hence there is no need of heating. And this is known as cooled method of staining or modified kinion staining method. Results of both will be same. So for smear examination, at least 10,000 acid fast bacilli per ml of sputum should be present. If they are 10,000 or more than that, then we will be able to detect them in the smear. And as regarding culture, a minimum of 10 to 100 viable bacilli per ml of sputum they are required in order to be positive for culture. This is how in Jaden staining picture look like under the microscope. These are acid fast bacilli which are rod shaped, curved one, and in case of MTB they are beaded one, whereas in case of Mycobacterium bovis they are smoothly stained and homogeneous staining will be there. No beading is there in case of Mycobacterium bovis or other atypical mycobacteria. And these blue are pus cells. So, under the blue background, we can see acid fast bacilli which are red in color or they are having color of strong carbolfoxin. Then we can proceed for fluorescent microscopy also. We can do fluorescent microscopy also. For that, fluorescent microscope with UV bulb is required. And the smear are stained with fluorescent dyes such as rhodamine and oramine. And this is again a sensitive method of diagnosing tuberculosis. And the tubercle bacilli, they give apple green type of fluorescence under the fluorescent microscope. So by this method also we can diagnose tuberculosis. Then culture is a gold standard method again. And at least 10 to 100 bacilli per ml of sputum are required in order to be grow over the culture media. Solid culture media are algae media, Lowenstein-Jensen media, which is egg-based medium in which glycerol is added. Liquid media, they are 7S9, 10 or 11. If agar is Middlebrook 7S9, 10 and 11, if agar is not added in them. This is how tubercle bacilli look like over the culture media. The colonies are rough, tough and buff for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Colonies are rough, tough and buff. Then this is 8-week growth of Mycobacterium tuberculosis on algae agar, Lowenstein-Jensen media. We can see rough, tough and buff colonies over the agar. They are there. Whereas in case of atypical mycobacteria, rapid growth will be there and colonies will be smooth, not rough, tough. The identifying features of MTB, they are straight or slightly curved beaded rods in a smear examination. MTB, they are slow growers. Rough, buff and tough colonies will be there after 4 to 6 weeks of culture. And growth is eugonic, means presence of glycerol in the culture media enhances the growth. Then they are biochemical tests. They are weak catalase positive, niacin positive, nitrate positive, neutral red positive. MTB, they are susceptible to pyrazinamide drug and they are pathogenic to guinea pig as compared to other mycobacteria. Now, how to perform drug susceptibility test? There are two methods. One method is phenotypic method. The other is genotypic method. Phenotypic method is, the methods are resistance ratio method, absolute concentration method, proportion method, and there is radiometric assay of detection of growth also. Then genotypic methods are DNA sequencing, solid phase hybridization, and PCR. These are various rapid methods of growing mycobacteria and to identifying them. These are automated methods. Mycobacteria growth indicator tube, then BACTEC 460. BACTEC method can be calorimetric, this can be radiometric, this can be fluorometric, various sensors are there which detect the presence of mycobacteria if they grow over the culture media. So these methods are basically depending upon which sensor is used and what type of technology we are using. The various new approach in diagnosing tuberculosis, they are cellular, depending upon cellular immune response, IGRA, or interferon gamma release assay. When blood comes in, blood containing T lymphocyte comes in contact with mycobacterium antigen, then T lymphocyte, they release gamma interferon, which can be detected. Then QuantiFERON TB gold test is there, T spot TB test is there, then various skin tests, they are there depending upon the cellular immune response of host against the tuberculosis bacilli. Humoral immune response can be detected in form of antibody detection test or serological test, which is not done nowadays, especially in endemic country like India. They are banned by WHO and Indian government. One more innovative method of diagnosing is gene expert method. This is automated system. You can see the gene expert or CBNAT cartridge. This is cartridge based nucleic acid amplification test, CBNAT test or gene expert test. What is the principle of this CBNAT test? We take a sample which should be free from blood, and the sample is inactivated with the sample reagent. Thereafter, this is transferred into the test cartridge. 2 ml of material is transferred into the test cartridge, and this cartridge is inserted into this machine, or we can say MTB-RIF test platform. We can shift, and approximately 4 tests can be done. This is cartridge based test. Now, next step is sample automatically is filtered out and washed in this automated method. Then there is ultrasonic lysis of filter captured organism to release the DNA. And after that, DNA molecule, they are mixed with the tri-PCR reagent. And finally, semi-nested real-time amplification and detection in integrated reaction tube is there. And the results are displayed like this. Whether MTB has been grown or not grown, MTB detected, that means grown. Then whether rifampicin resistance is there or not there, this is also detected. So this is the added advantage of this CBNAT or gene expert test, that not only we detect in the sample whether MTB are present or not, but resistance to rifampicin can also be detected via this method, and this is nowadays used extensively for diagnosing tuberculosis. But sample can be anything, but it should be free from blood. Now there is one more method, loop mediated isothermal amplification or LAMP technique, which in which a small heating device is required which runs at high temperature, multiple primer set are added, and directly this can be done over the sputum, and closed system is required, no risk of contamination, minimal instrumentation is required, and this is a fast method of diagnosing tuberculosis. And in this, visual detection of MTB is done, no instrumentation is required, a precipitate is formed which is detected via this technique, which is known as LAMP technique or loop mediated isothermal amplification technique. Now there is Mantoux test, which is based on cellular immune response of host. In this, we inject 5 tuberculin unit of PPD, purifying protein extract of tubercle bacilli, into the forearm of individual in which we want to do this Mantoux test or tuberculin test. And then we call the patient after 48 to 72 hours. Then this type of reaction will be there over the forearm. This is induration, then erythema is there. So we have to measure the induration if it via a scale. If it is 10 millimeter or more than that, this is labeled as positive, means Mantoux test positive. If the measurement is in between 5 to 9 millimeter, then that means equivocal results they are there. And if the measurement is less than 5 millimeter, then that means test is negative. So this is how Mandu's test is done. Then tubercular lymphadenitis, FNAC is a gold test for TB lymphadenitis, especially in HIV infected person. So FNAC can be done of lymph nodes, and this can be done the same day in healthcare facility, and this has a low rate of adverse effect, and this has a high yield of diagnosing tuberculosis. Now the serological test for diagnosing tuberculosis, they have been banned by Government of India as well as WHO, so they should not be done for diagnosing tuberculosis at all. Thank you very much, and please don't forget to give your comment in comment section.